Hello, this is Jeff Lighthall, Chairman of the VA CPR Committee. The interpretation of cardiac rhythms during arrest is an area of great consternation for co-team leaders. Artifacts introduced during chest compressions, errant lead placements, and even the term pulseless electrical activity can all conspire to produce delays in the recognition and identification of terminal arrhythmias. Humans will exit this life while exhibiting one of two terminal arrhythmia syndromes. One is shockable, where prompt adherence to a defibrillation algorithm is essential, while the non-shockable pathway calls for vasoconstricting medicines during chest compressions and search for treatable causes. As a co-team leader, it is absolutely essential that you rapidly identify the correct syndrome with minimal or no interruptions of chest compressions and deliver prompt therapy, especially to those with the more survivable shockable rhythms. This video will provide brief examples of arrhythmias and ask you to identify whether they are shockable or not. Say out loud, this is, fill in the blank, and it is a shockable or non-shockable rhythm. We ask you that you practice expressing your thoughts out loud, and if unsure, ask others on their team if they see things differently. Let's begin. Okay, you walk into a room, CPR is in progress, and you see this mess on the monitor. During a real quick ventilation break, you're able to capture a couple beats of the underlying rhythm, shown here. So what do you think? Is this a shockable rhythm or not? This is not a shockable rhythm. This is sinus tachycardia. Your adventures continue. You're now in another room, CPR is in progress, and you're looking at the screen. You hear the compression count get up near 30, and your attention turns to the screen during ventilation, where you get a cleaner look at everything without CPR artifact. What do you think? Is this shockable or not? That was atrial fibrillation. It is not shockable. Here's another resting patient. Hook up to the monitor and CPR in progress as you enter the room. What do you think? Is this shockable or not? Here's how things look with a break in CPR. Break's taking a little bit too long, but this is clearly ventricular tachycardia, and it is a shockable arrhythmia. Okay, here's a similar patient. What do you think? Now with a break in CPR, you get a little bit of a better look at what's going on. Again, this is a prolonged look. But this is torsades, and it is shockable. Okay, we'll try another one here. Take a look. This is with CPR. What do you think? Shockable? Not? Now we're going to hold CPR for a couple seconds. And what you see is a baseline that looks very much like flutter. It could be fib flutter. Doesn't particularly matter in this case. This is not a shockable rhythm. Okay, here we go. CPR going on here. Different kind of like spike activity. Looks like it could be sinus. Looks like it could be atrial fibrillation. Number of possibilities here. Maybe a little asystole. Look at that. Could be fine V-fib. This is where you have to be really good, because if this is a shockable rhythm, you can save somebody and they'll have a better outcome. So let's take a look with holding some chest compressions here. And what we see is pretty coarse V-fib. It's definitely a shockable rhythm. A little bit more. Okay, back in action. Take a look at this one, see what you think. Ooh. What do you think? Yep, this is asystole. It is not shockable. One could imagine maybe a little bit of coarse, very fine V-fib. A lead change might confirm that, but really, this is someone that needs a lot of chest compressions, not electrical therapy at this point. We have reached the conclusion of this module. More information can be found by doing a Google search for VA CPR. That's the VA Palo Alto CPR website, VAPA CPR. Thank you and good luck.